The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school. But I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports, athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school, but I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamiu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments, championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are
St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Roger State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Roger State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school. But I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society. Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives. The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Yeah.
Welcome to the UMAC Center here in Tulsa, Oklahoma, where it is Championship Sunday for the 2017 Heartland Women's Conference Tournament. I'm joined on my right side, Drew Brent, on my left side, Corey Riggs. Drew, it's been a crazy 3 days of basketball.
Absolutely a crazy 3 days of basketball. We've seen a couple of upsets, and now here we are, Championship Sunday, Jose, with a couple of rematches. We're anticipating a big crowd today and a great basketball atmosphere here at the UMAC.
Corey, I've been through so many games, I really can't remember how we even got here. Can you recap that for us?
Well, the easy part is I think we started on Thursday, and we can kind of start there. And for this side of the bracket, the women's side of the bracket, it's been chalk the whole way through. The number one seed made it through on the top side of the bracket, St. Edward's, got a 67-49 victory over Texas A&M International. Then St. Ed's, the Hilltoppers, took down UFAS, 67-60, but on the bottom side of the bracket, you had a 2-3 matchup that saw St. Mary's fall to Lubbock Christian by a big total, 70-51, and Lubbock Christian, of course, the defending conference champ, the defending national champ, and they are looking to get a second straight Heartland Conference victory here today, but St. Edward's, that's going to be a tall task.
Tall task indeed, and we'll see how it turns out. Coming up after this, we got some highlights, and then the championship game.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
An incredible job by Miss Natalie Evans with our national anthem as we are ready for Championship Sunday, the UMAC here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. Championship game one of two on this Sunday, the Heartland Conference, the women's championship, just like it was a year ago. The same teams, but different seeds and different roads as we look at Lubbock Christian. Lubbock Christian, the Lady Chaps, with a record of 19-10. They will take on the St. Edward's Hilltoppers with a record of 19-8. Corey Riggs, Drew Brent, our sideline reporter, Jose Harbor, and the entire JBM production team. Day 4 of 4, Drew, and we are ready to crown 2 champs.
Absolutely. You know, what's interesting about this is that it's a rematch on both sides of the bracket. And as you mentioned, St. Edward's was here last year, but they were the 5 seed last year. It was very much an upset special for what it is that they were trying to do. This year, they find themselves in the top spot, hoping to secure that run to the Big Dance. Coach J.J. Real has really coached her team up, and we'll tell you, looking at Lexi Fothery, Abby Hopper, these are two players to watch over on that St. Edward's squad.
For Lubbock Christian, they are coached by Steve Gomez, 14 seasons at Lubbock Christian, a perfect 5-0 record in Heartland Conference tournament play. On the other side, well, Drew told you, J.J. Rio and the St. Edward's Hilltoppers, a 6-3 record in the conference tournament for J.J. Real. She is the coach of the year. She's got a couple of all-conference players on her team as well. Shakira Barnes, their stellar point guard, is a first conference all-teamer. Lexi Fothery, a second team all-conference selection. And Keani Clark, that was on your screen just a moment ago from Round Rock, Texas, an all-conference honorable mention. But there is Shakira Barnes, and for my money, partner, she is the engine of this offensive supercar, race car that J.J. Real gets to operate.
Unquestionably, their partner, you're absolutely right. She's also the team's leading scorer for the year. And, you know, between her, Keani Clark on the inside, and then Lexi Fothery cutting and running, this is a St. Edward's squad that is very dangerous, hoping to take that into the NCAA tournament.
The all-time series is in Lubbock Christian's favor. The Lady Chaparrals lead the all-time series, 8 wins against 5 losses. The last time these two clubs got together in Lubbock, Texas, it took to overtime to be able to decide that matchup. It was won by LCU 84-80 in the extra period. Our officials for today's women's championship game, Dari Slaybaugh, Jeff Faulkner, and Charles Carroll, the men in stripes, here for this championship game. Tess Bruffy and Abby Hopper are ready to jump it at center court, and Lubbock Christian has the opening tip, and here we go.
Championship on the line, partner.
Bailey Heist works the ball around the perimeter, gives way to Gaddis. Outside, Bruffy for 3, she leaves it short. Big rebound control by Keani Clark. Down low to Clark, outside. The 3-ball won't go. Right off the bat, St. Edward's Bailey Hill. She had injured an elbow in yesterday's game, Drew, but she looks to be good to go here.
Absolutely. You know, she came out of that game in a lot of pain. She still seems to be favoring that elbow just a little bit, but it's the championship, and you have to suit up and get ready.
You know that better than anybody, bud. A third member of our broadcast team is Jose Harbor. He's working the sidelines. Jose, what do you have?
Thanks, guys. I was able to listen into the timeout there, or before the game, for Coach Real's team. She was telling her kids, look, we got to stay in the moment. This is your time. This is your moment. We got to go out there and perform. And when she means by stay in the moment, too, she was telling her kids, if you miss a shot, which is going to happen, don't be thinking about the missed shot. Be excited for your opportunity to play defense. She really wants them to be thinking about what's going on right now, not any type of mistakes. Guys?
Right now, there's a pretty good reason to be excited about their offense, as Keani Clark, with an up-and-under move, gets the first 2 points of the game and the foul.
Keani Clark is such a presence on the inside. We've been talking about this all week long. She has the ability to run and gun. She has the ability to make plays underneath the paint. Now watch her on defense. She'll be a dominant presence on the inside, too. Keani Clark is an unsung hero for this Lady Hilltopper team.
Her 80th make at the charity stripe. And now Gaddis deadens her dribble, has nowhere to go, so she just shoots over the defense for the first 2 points for Lubbock Christian.
Delaney Gaddis is one of those players that can make a lot of things happen from a lot of different areas on the court. You can't leave her open anywhere, and even if you've got her covered up, she'll shoot over the top of you like she did just then.
Barnes goes with the left hand, no good. 6'4", Tess Bruffy, the conference player of the year, with her first rebound, and that one's batted away, and Jose told us J.J. Real wants her team to look for opportunities on the defensive end. There's a forced turnover. So we've played 2 minutes here. Three-pointer from the corner won't go. Rebound controlled by the Lady Shaps. All-conference honorable mention, Bailey Heist brings it up now. Bruffy's already taken 1-3 this time. She'll take a few steps in. Drives on Clark, leaves it short on the front of the iron. Clark with the rebound. Gianni Clark with a pair of rebounds already. See if Fathery's shot will fall here, and of course it does, partner. She's one of the best shooters we've seen in this tournament.
You know, we mentioned it last night. When Lexi Fathery is in the game, it's instant offense. And, you know, one of the things that we have to analyze and talk about was last night's game. She got an early foul trouble, and it really caused some problems for St. Edward's. You know, but she is an instant spark plug for offense, and they have to watch her wherever she is on the court.
She shoots 46% from the floor. That was her 99th make of the 2016-17 campaign. They'll send it back around to her again. The three ball, but of course, Lexi Fathery for three more.
Well, we just got done talking about how she was an instant offensive spark plug. And there it is from downtown. It's 8-2 St. Edward's.
Up six here, the Lady Shaps need a bucket. They kind of ran away and hid in this game a year ago. Final score in that one was 75-52, a big margin of victory. But right now, it's the other team on the scoreboard that has the lead, and they've got the ball again because Keani Clark is cleaning the glass. 3 points, three rebounds for number 33.
Well, but Christian finds itself in some unfamiliar territory here, Corey. They're trailing, and they don't seem to have their rhythm. Coach Steve Gomez pacing on the sidelines.
With good reason. That three-pointer airballed, last touch by Tess Bruffy. So it'll stay with the Hilltoppers. Olivia Robertson checks into the game for Bobby Chitsey, the Wall, Texas native. St. Edward's Hilltoppers, winners of four of their last five games. They have been in three title games in the last 5 years. Looking for a title win here. And right now, Keani Clark has taken it upon herself to ensure that. 5 points, three boards for Keani Clark.
She's got half the team's offense here in the early going.
Lubbock Christian needs an answer. This is a big run. They go down low. How about Hannah Harbin for her first two? She had 14 points, five rebounds, and four assists in the semifinal win against St. Mary's. Skip pass all the way across to Bailey Hill. Shakira Barnes with nowhere to go. They send it all the way across to Featherly. Fatherly, baseline drive, no, and there's a tie-up here with 5:13 to go. Alternating possession arrow will keep the ball with the Hilltoppers. Short shot clock here, the ball tipped into backcourt. Running it down is Gaddis. Can she finish? Yes, she can.
Nice little stutter step move that time by Gaddis to have Lexi Fathery overrun her. Fathery was right on her tail trying to disrupt the layup, but that time that nice little stutter step underneath created the scoring opportunity.
Hit the brakes and watch them fly right by. Here's Bailey Hill, a point blank miss. Rebound controlled by Olivia Robertson. Robertson just into the game a moment ago. Gaddis had the last bucket. Now Tess Bruffy drives the kick out. Lost, but it comes back to the Lady Shaps. 13 on the shot clock. Right-handed turnaround jumper won't go. Clark, another rebound. 5 points, four boards, Keani Clark. The transfer from UT Pan American to St. Edward's. 10-6 now. The Hilltoppers want an answer. Instead, they get a travel. Clark was tied up. She took an extra step. That'll take us to our first timeout. Great action here in the Heartland Conference. Women's Championship, the 15th annual tournament here in Tulsa. Back with more in the UMAC in a minute.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamiu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
Back in the UMAC, everybody. Corey Riggs, Drew Brent, sideline reporter Jose Harbor here to bring you game one of two on the championship Sunday in Tulsa. A great start for SCU as they got out to a big lead. Lubbock Christian, though, Drew, in the last couple of possessions has been able to trim the lead down to four.
Exactly, and they've done that with using some stutter steps. They've done that by going and trying to create some opportunities in transition. They've also done it by just throwing the ball up over the defender. Sounds pretty easy, sounds pretty cliche, but a lot of times when you've got a hand in your face, that scoring opportunity is so much more difficult. They've had to find ways to get back into it.
Reach in foul gonna be called underneath the basket. They got Lexi Fothery, and the first thing you said about the semifinal win for St. Edwards was that Fothery was in foul trouble the whole time. Here she is getting an early foul again.
Lexi Fothery has to really watch that.
Wow, that ball spent all the way around and almost set on the back iron. Tess Bruffy still scoreless in this one. The player of the year having a hard time finding her mojo here in the championship. Fothery, three, no, way too strong. Rebound right into the gut of Lubbock Christian. That was Goble, and now we've got a foul on the other end. Knocked out of bounds. Possibly, no, it is a foul. That foul against number 14 for St. Edwards, Haley Jolly.
You know, you were talking about foul trouble in the early going just a few moments ago for Lexi Fothery. Now Haley Jolly's got one as well. But Lexi Fothery, as we mentioned, is that offensive spark plug. She had to sit a lot of minutes yesterday just simply because of the fouls that she had.
Another air ball miss from the corner, that time out of the hands of Bailey Heist. Hilltoppers, chance to add to the four-point advantage here. Shakira Barnes goes left to right, and it comes back to her. Father, he skips it all the way across, down low to Hopper. She drives baseline, scoop shot won't go. Rebound controlled by Lubbock Christian's Hannah Harbin. Under 3 minutes to go here in quarter number one. Gaddis, she's got 4 points. Comes back to Delaney Gaddis now. She'll drive, double team comes her way, toss to Bruffy. She puts the left-handed runner up and in. You can't keep a good player down. Tess Bruffy, her first two.
And she did so inside the paint. Lubbock Christian really likes those inside shots, trying to find ways to score inside as part of their MO. They hadn't been able to do that so far. Consecutive possessions they've been able to.
Abby Hopper, another head fake, then the feed to Fothery. It won't go, but there's Hopper for the rebound. Hopper had career highs of 16 points and 10 rebounds against Newman in the quarterfinal. The offense runs through her again. Hopper with the ball. Down to Guillory. The double team comes. She ducks up and under, has her shot partially blocked. There's the takeaway for the Lady Shaps. Chance to tie it up or take the lead on this possession.
St. Edwards seems to have gone cold here in this latter part of the first quarter after starting so strong.
Now an offensive foul away from the ball. Wasn't sure who they got on that. Was waiting for him to put it up on the scoreboard. It's Hannah Harbin. Harbin's first, the team's second. Team fouls even at two apiece for St. Ed's and Lubbock Christian. So St. Edwards dodges a bullet there, Drew. See if they can capitalize on the opportunity. Barnes, a one-on-one game. She gives way to Clark. Along the baseline, spins, fadeaway, short. Rebound pulled down by Gaddis. Lubbock Christian again with a chance to draw even. There have been no ties and no lead changes in this first quarter. It has been St. Edward's wire to wire. Now a foul on 14, Haley Jolly. That's her second, the team's third.
It's interesting to note here too, St. Edward's, it's not just father, it's all of them who have seemingly gone cold shooting short in consecutive possessions.
Well, they've only had two scores so far. Clark and Fothery have combined for all 10 of the Hilltoppers' points. How about a long three? Claire Bruffy into the game. Claire Bruffy, the sister, the senior of Tess Bruffy. Both from Lubbock, Texas. Both part of the Lubbock Titans, a great homeschool team, along with Hannah Harbin. And there's a foul on the aforementioned Hannah Harbin as she tried to put a body against Keani Clark.
This is the kind of play that we were expecting from Keani Clark. As we mentioned, she can run and gun. She can move up the floor, but she is also very, very good in the paint. And she's a heck of a free throw shooter, too. Keani Clark is one of those rare players who you can put almost anywhere, and she will produce.
In the quarterfinal win against the Newman Jets, she tied a career high with 19 rebounds. Today, she's a scoring machine. She's got 7 points and 4 rebounds. Keani Clark, the difference in this one so far as the Hilltoppers lead the Lady Shaps 12-8. Final 45 seconds here in the first quarter. Bruffy, the lob pass into Chitsey. She had been out for a little while. First trip back in. She tries to drive on Guillory and she travels. Good defense that time by Sandra Guillory, the Austin, Texas native. A transfer from Sam Houston State, who averages about 3 points and 3 rebounds a night for J.J. Real.
You have to play smart. Even if you're playing in a rush, you have to play smart. Don't take those extra steps. This is championship basketball. You have to be mentally prepared.
6 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Ball mishandled here, dropped by Cunningham. The ball is loose. The Lady Shaps come up with it. They've got plenty of time here. 10 seconds for one more play as they trail by 4. Bruffy starts her dribble at the free throw line. Spins, shoots over Clark. No. And that will be the end of the first quarter as Cunningham was unable to control it for St. Edward's. We have played one. St. Edward's leads Lubbock Christian 12-8.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Welcome back to the UMAC, everybody. Championship Sunday here on the women's side of the Heartland Conference bracket. Thanks for joining us live online at heartlandsports.org. Look at some of the numbers from the first quarter. Both teams drew shooting similar percentages and not a lot from three-point land in this one so far.
Only Lexi Fothery has one. 0-for-3 for Lubbock Christian, 1-for-4 for St. Edward's. Not a lot of scoring from beyond the arc.
Lubbock Christian late in the season is averaging about 9 or 10 threes a game. See if that doesn't change in the story here. Now there's going to be a reach-in foul from behind. They're going to get Abby Hopper. Hopper picks up her first. St. Edward's first here in the second quarter. Of course, the fouls in women's college basketball reset from quarter to quarter. So we wipe off what we had in the first quarter. It's 1-0 here in the second. Lubbock Christian down 4. They go back to their player of the year. Bruffy shakes, bakes, sends the shot up. It's no good. Rebound by Abby Hopper. Hopper with 3 rebounds so far in this contest. Shakira Barnes has been quiet so far in this one. They go to Clark, an unselfish dish, but Hopper misses it from right in front of the rim, and Bruffy with the board. Jose Harbor worked both benches during the media timeout. Jose, what did you hear the coaches talk about?
Thanks, guys. Yeah, I was listening into both timeouts. SEU coach, Coach Real, telling her players, the offensive side will work itself out. We need to keep doing what we're doing on the defensive side, stay in the moment of the D. She wants number 13 to make Lubbock Christian decide what they want to do on that 3-2 zone. Do they want to attack the point guard or defend the wing? She really wants her point guard, SEU's point guard, to make Lubbock Christian decide what they want to do. On Lubbock Christian's side, Coach Gomez is telling them, don't get too focused in your lane on the zone. We need to help out. Spread the floor, guys.
We'll see about that help defense as the Lubbock Christian alum himself, a graduate of 1988. Steve Gomez played for legendary Chaparral coach John Copeland. Now he's a coach himself here 14 years in and has made the transition for Lubbock Christian from NAIA to Division II and already has a national championship. Clark, fadeaway Jay, too strong. Bruffy, another rebound. Tess Bruffy, 2 points, three boards here. 90 seconds into the second quarter of play. Both of these teams looking for their second ever Heartland Conference championship crowns. Robertson drives, she gives it to Chitsey, up and under, and two more points for Bobby Chitsey. 15 points in the quarterfinal and the semifinal, Drew. For Chitsey, she has been a model of consistency.
Well, and it's that underneath game that Bobby Chitsey is so good at. She can find the points from the baseline and inside the paint, just like Keon and Clark did just then. You're watching these two teams try to find and establish their game inside.
Keon Clark leads all scorers with 9 now. 9 points, 4 boards. She's perfect at the free throw line. Her team's holding on to a 2-point lead. Hilltoppers defense gonna need to stiffen up here. Bruffy off the dribble, goes up and underneath. Her circus shot won't go. She gets her own rebound. Out to Cunyas for 3. That one too strong. A second offensive rebound won't go. Somebody take the lid off the basket for the Lady Shafts. Shakira Barnes brings it up. She has it here. Takes a step in at the free throw line. Hopper for 3, and she snaps the net. Abby Hopper's 17th made 3 of the season, over 160 points this year. Her team's now up 5.
St. Edward's and LCU were tied just 60 seconds ago. Now St. Edward's on a 5-0 run.
Lexi Fothery covering, bullet pass from Bailey Heist down low. And the foul underneath will go against Lexi Cunningham. That's Cunningham's 2nd, the Hilltoppers' 3rd foul here in the second quarter. Cunyas will key the offense here, the Canyon, Texas native. Underneath her own basket, looking for somebody to come open, and Chitsey grabs it out on the wing. Lubbock Christian trying to find a way to attack the defense. Chitsey steps into a 3 too much. That's out of bounds, last touch by Bruffy. Bruffy batting that one out of bounds. Barnes back with the rock here. The lead and the ball, 17-12 for the Hilltoppers. Abby Hopper just knocked down 1-3. She fakes on one. They go down low to Clark, and Keani Clark will go back to the free throw line. Right now, the low post presence that Keani Clark is bringing is paying dividends for St. Edward's.
It's that inside game. We talked about it so much. Points in the paint. 8 or 6 so far for St. Edward's, all of them coming from Kenny Clark.
Clark, 4 for 4 at the free throw line today. Watch this rebound as she shakes and bakes Bruffy. Doesn't get the make, but she's making them here at the line. Her first miss of the day. She's now 4 of 5. The lead now back to 6 for St. Edward's. Bruffy can't get the handle on it, but I think Hopper touched it last, and she did. Hannah Harbin back into the ball game, the
Lubbock, Texas native. 12 points and 7 rebounds for Hannah in the quarterfinal win against Newman. She currently sits on 241 points for this, her senior season. Cunyas still in, looking to attack with the left hand, and it lips over and goes. Caitlin Cunyas' first 2 points for the freshman guard. That cuts the difference back to 4. Hopper finds Fothery. Set shot for Lexi. No good. Rebound to Harbin again. Hannah Harbin with 2 points and 3 rebounds. 3 ball on the way, trying to make it a 1-point game. No. Hopper gets the pull. Shakira Barnes still scoreless in this one. Content to distribute down to Kalani Clark, Keani Clark, and why not? Keani Clark is on fire. 12 points to lead her team. 12 points to lead all scorers. Her team in this one, it's 20 to 14. They still hold on to the 6-point edge. Double team now down low. Cunyas passes out of it. Harbin between the circles, 10 on the shot clock. Fothery jumps up and down in front of Chitsey. She finds Tess Bruffy. Spins in, gets her shot to go. She spun once, she spun twice. The Toppers bench wanted a travel. They didn't get it, and she scores.
Shakira Barnes will take it across the time stripe. You mentioned that she is still scoreless. Keani Clark, however, is not with 12. And as you mentioned over here on this defensive side, Keani Clark was quite the presence underneath in the paint as well. Would not surprise me if she's all-tournament team.
We'll find out about the all-tournament selections later today. Now, the lob to Chitsey. She backs down Abby Hopper. Made that one look easy for Bobby Chitsey. 212 points, 81 rebounds coming into today for the sophomore, Bobby Chitsey. Clark again this time. She'll send it back out. The 3, no, off the left side of the cylinder. But Hopper's knocked him down from there before. It's a 2-point game. Lubbock Christian wants 2. They go back to Chitsey. The double team comes her way. Inside out game. Bruffy for 3. Too strong off the heel. Rebound controlled by Bailey Hill. And they knock it out of bounds. This will be a timeout here, a great matchup. Lubbock Christian University, St. Edward's University, putting on a show here in Tulsa. More on the Heartland Conference Sports Network after this.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown. It's what you do. If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
Academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Lubbock Christian just 2 points away from tying this game up with 3:43 to go until halftime. Steve Gomez talking to his troops. The shooting numbers, Drew, still eerily similar, and not a lot of three-pointers falling.
Only 2 in the entire game, both for St. Edward's, Abby Hopper and Lexi Fothery. Check this out. Lubbock Christian is 0-for-7 from beyond the arc. Tess Bruffy has missed 2.
Lubbock Christian does have the scoring edge so far here in the second quarter. They lead the scoring individually in this period, 10-8. St. Edward's, though, a chance to pad the lead and get it back. Hill finds Guillory, a Euro step, but not a Euro step as she travels. 2 substitutions for Coach Gomez as he sends Delaney Gaddis and Olivia Robertson back into the game. D defensive change this time for St. Edwards. Man-to-man coverage this time. Clark coming out to guard Tess Bruffy. Lady Shamps working around the perimeter. 7 on the shot clock, 6 on the shot clock. Robertson gives it up. 3 ball on the way. No, but an offensive rebound underneath. And Lubbock Christian has a second chance. Good offensive board for Allie Harris.
Make that 0 for 8 from beyond the arc for Lubbock Christian.
They're going to try and shoot their way out of it, Drew. I guarantee it. Now they go down low for a higher percentage shot, but Bruffy in the middle of a double team. Here's another 3. Their 8th try won't go. That one's going to be out of bounds back to St. Edwards. And they are ice cold right now from the outside, partner.
They have looked at that shot 9 different times, and so far they have not been able to hit a single one. 0 for 9 from beyond the arc, and typically you'll see Tess Bruffy knock up 1 or 2 in the early going, but Lubbock Christian ice cold from downtown.
St. Edwards isn't exactly lighting up the lamp from outside, but 2 3-pointers right now in a low-scoring affair is all the difference. How about a third? Bailey Heist tries to light the lamp. She's off the mark. Robertson with the rebound. Ball comes back to Olivia Robertson. She finds Delaney Gaddis. There's going to be a bump foul as they try to go into the paint on Bailey Hill. Hill's first personal, the team's 4th here against St. Edwards. Team fouls 4 for the Hilltoppers, only 1 for the Lady Chaparrals. Gaddis from Glenwood Springs, Colorado, an Otero Junior College product. Tries to get the inbounds. They slice down the lane, the ball on the hardwood. 1st and 10, who's got it? Tie up. We'll send the ball to St. Edwards, and there were a number of collisions on the floor. Allie Harris gets up holding her left eye. Lexi Fothery a little slow to get up, that big knee brace on the left knee of Fothery. She has to attend to her knee brace. She missed 8 games early on with the injury. She's been a warrior ever since, though. Fothery, 15 points, 4 rebounds, the team's leading scorer. This is the 20th game of the season for the St. Edward star, Lexi Fothery. Both teams gonna say goodbye to a number of seniors as this season draws to a close. A 2-point game again, and a rare mental mistake by Keani Clark as she shuffled her feet.
And that's twice in 3 possessions that St. Edward's has been called for traveling. You have to make sure that you are playing the mental game.
Turnovers pretty much dead even, 5 for Lubbock Christian. 4 for St. Edwards, so not a huge disparity there. Actually, it's 5-5 after that travel by Clark. Lubbock Christian has yet to be able to tie this game up. They try to take the lead with yet another 3, and the cold streak continues. Fothery with the rebound here. J.J. Real talking to her stellar senior point guard, Shakira Barnes. She has started all 27 games this season for the Hilltoppers. 15 on the shot clock, the final minute. A rare mid-range jumper, draws nothing. Goes out of bounds to LCU. Bailey Heist checks back in for Coach Gomez. Out goes Allie Harris.
It's a low-scoring affair for both teams so far in this game, and you would usually look at that score and say, well, it's a defensive battle. It's not a defensive battle. Both of these teams have just gone ice cold. Cannot hit the shots. There have been plenty of open looks for both squads and cannot get them to fall.
Lubbock Christian. Now with 40 seconds on the clock, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Can't imagine they take another 3 here, but they may have to against the shot clock. Bruffy with 3, with 2, NBA range, no. Off the heel, an offensive rebound, and look at that. The stick back for number 32, Gaddis.
And we're tied up finally, partner. First time since we were knotted up at 12-12.
20-20 our score. Shakira Barnes is going to be able to hold for 1 here. The final shot. Can St. Edwards take the lead back here in the final 5 seconds? Hill throws it away with 2, with 1. She has to shoot. She makes it in front of the buzzer. Bailey Hill from an injured elbow to a buzzer beater for a three-point lead as time expires here in the first half. Our scores, St. Edward's 23, Lubbock Christian 20. There you see another look at it there on the instant replay. A fantastic finish to a great first two quarters of play here in Tulsa. We will be back with the second half of action after this break on the Heartland Conference Sports Network. Stay tuned, everybody.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports. Athletes do.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Heartland Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that They're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school, but I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play, you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University, empowering graduates to transform society.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamiu.edu.
Whoever you are, whoever you want to be, find your future with us. We are UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments, championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to Geico. It's what you do.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Halftime is drawing to a close, and we are just about set to get underway here in the third quarter of play in our Sunday championship of the Heartland Women's Basketball Tournament. The game featuring St. Edward's and Lubbock Christian. St. Edward's Hilltoppers up by three over the Lubbock Christian Lady Chaparrals, 23-20. I'm Corey Riggs alongside Drew Brent and our sideline reporter, Jose Harbor. Just about 7 seconds away from getting back to basketball here inside the UMAC. Some of the numbers from halftime. Lubbock Christian shot 31% from the floor, Drew. 100% from the free throw line. They only had two opportunities. And then that 0-for-11 from three-point land.
I think that tells the story of the game right there when you're not able to establish your perimeter shooting. Their points in the paint, however, 14, so they have had some luck inside.
When they've scored, like they're trying to now here with Chitsey, they've taken a high percentage shot. Chitsey ends up on her back. St. Edward's comes the other end. The Hilltoppers shot 32% in the first half, 3 of 9 from three-point land and 4 of 5 from the charity stripe. How about a 4 three-pointer? This one from Bailey Hill. Bailey Hill knocks down another one. St. Edward's doubles their lead here in the opening moments of the second half, 26-20. Send the ball all the way around the horn. That three-pointer a little flat. Chitsey with the offensive rebound, and she gets the follow.
Lubbock Christian really needed that bucket. St. Edward's was looking to establish some momentum early, create their perimeter shots, and establish some momentum. And if Lubbock Christian had allowed them to go on a run, it may have been insurmountable. That time, that bucket was more for momentum's sake than anything else.
Bobby Chitsey now with 6 points. The turnaround jumper by Clark, no good. Last touched by the Hilltoppers.
Rare miss from Keani Clark on the inside. She's been such a beast and a presence in the paint. Tess Bruffy said no thank you.
4 of 7 from the floor today for Clark. 4 of 5 from the charity stripe. She's got 12 points and 5 rebounds. Her 12 points leads all scores. 90 seconds in, and the game is a 4-point one. See what changes Coach Gomez has made to the Lubbock Christian offense. Bruffy, a great move around to her right, and a finish with the left hand as she shoots up and over Keani Clark. Jose Harbor met with both coaches during the halftime intermission. Jose, what did they talk to you about?
I appreciate that, guys. Yeah, Coach Reel was telling me, look, we still got to be excited to defend. Offenses will keep coming. We just got to keep defending on our end. And they said that buzzer beater three was a nice momentum, but you can't hang on that. Second half's a totally different beast. I talked to Gomez. He really didn't have much to say. He said, you know, I asked him about the first half. He said 23 points, giving up 23 points ain't bad, but only scoring 20 ain't any better. And I asked him about Keconi Clark, and he said, yeah, she's a good player, guys.
Well, succinct, if nothing else, from Steve Gomez. And I tell you what, Drew, they say you don't have to worry about the three, but Bailey Hill got one to end the quarter, got one to start the quarter. She's 3 of 6 from three-point land for all 9 of her points. Now the lead's 5.
And here is, if you are Lubbock Christian, here is the concern, is that you now have Keanu Clark on the inside, and you have Bailey Hill on the outside, two major scoring threats who have done the bulk of the scoring for St. Edward's. Couple that with the fact that you've got Lexi Fothery, who is consistent offensive danger, and St. Edward's becomes much more dangerous.
Hopper that time has her shot partially blocked. Lubbock Christian was the nation's number one team in blocked shots a year ago. This year, they're number 3 in the nation in blocks per game. Tess Bruffy calls for the ball. Chitsey takes her own number here, puts it up and off the window with the left hand, and it's a three-point game, 29-26. Hilltoppers looking to stay on top here. Fothery skips it all the way across to Hill. Shakira Barnes has it scored. She still has it scored, but that was a good look as she pulled up inside the free throw line. Barnes 0 for 3 on the afternoon. Chitsey's had the hot hand here. She'll go to work on Hopper, backs her down, spins to the right. She does not get the shot to go, but she gets the foul and will go to the line. Hopper will pick up the foul. That's her second. The team's first here in quarter number three. See the good position that time by Hopper, but she just kind of closed the hands over the top of Chitsey during her shooting motion. That led to the foul. Bobby Chitsey sees the first one bounce off the rim. An 84% free throw shooter on the season from Wall High School in Wall, Texas. That was her first free throw attempt of the day. She's 56 of 67. She goes 1 of 2 here. Drew, this 2-point number right here is the mark they've kind of hung around here, 29-27. St. Edward's always seems to have an answer. Bailey Hill, a miss that time from outside, the young lady who's shooting about 50% from downtown.
Once again, you saw that right there was another scoring opportunity for St. Edward's, this scoring threat. Keani Clark on the inside, and then you have Bailey Hill on the outside. And once again, Lexi Fothery underneath, it's a danger.
Bruffy worked it down, sends it all the way around the horn. Harbin can't hit anything. There's 5 on the shot clock. That didn't draw iron. Gaddis has got to shoot. They do not get the shot off prior to the shot clock. Shot clock violation gives the ball back to the Toppers.
That's just great defense that time by St. Edward's, closing in. And then you saw them swarming to the basketball. You could not ask for a better defensive stand by St. Edward's, and that is a momentum killer if you are LCU.
Hilltoppers defeated Texas A&M International. They defeated the University of Arkansas Fort Smith. They have yet to be able to pull away, though, from the Lady Chaparrals. Guillory's miss from the left block won't go. Another big rebound for Tess Bruffy. 6 points, 6 boards for the Heartland Conference Player of the Year.
Both teams struggling offensively so far.
Well, neither team is lighting up the scoreboard, but St. Edward's always seems to have an answer. This time, though, Guillory commits the foul in the paint. That is her first, the team second, and we will step away. More to come from the 15th annual Heartland Conference Tournament after this timeout.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Steve Gomez talking to the Lady Champs during that timeout. His team still only down 2 here, Drew. Neither team able to really run away and hide here in a low-scoring affair in Tulsa.
Absolutely. You took a look at the statistics during the break and the things that jump out at me. Lubbock Christian 0 for 14 from behind the three-point line. Rebounds, though, a big discrepancy there. LCU actually controls the boards 28-19.
They have done that. Block shots and rebounds has been a hallmark of Lubbock Christian. They've gotten another foul on St. Edward's here. They had a foul right before the break on Guillory. Now they get Shakira Barnes, her first personal, the team's third foul here in the third quarter of play. 4:50 to go. Harbin with it. Looks at Bruffy, thinks better of it, sends it around the horn. Gaddis now to Bailey Heist, the all-conference honorable mention. Down low now, Bruffy drives, tries to split a pair of Hilltoppers and is fouled. Tess Bruffy will go to the line. Tess Bruffy, the junior, won the conference player of the week honors 5 times this season. She's posted 2 double-doubles at this tournament. That gives her 11 on the season. Knocking down a free throw here. She even had 1 triple-double against St. Mary's. 21 points, 13 rebounds, and 10 blocks. Coming into today, Drew, she is now over 1,200 points for her career at Lubbock Christian.
That's your conference player of the year right there, and has had a lot of success at LCU. Been relatively quiet this game, however.
She's got 6 points. It's a 1-point game now. St. Edward's the 1-point lead. The ball, Fothery drives in, kicks it out. Clark now with 15 seconds on the shot, Clark. Skip pass now, tapped into the air and out of bounds. It'll stay with St. Edward's. Jose Harbor has more from the sidelines.
Thanks, guys. I got a little information on Keani Clark. She's a special education major. Her typical day starts at 4:40 a.m., which goes through practice, school, lunch, hanging out with friends, and she goes to bed at 10. She likes to have dinner with her parents since they are so close. And she says even though she's exhausted most days, she can't imagine life without basketball. Guys?
That's a great story, Jose. Thanks for sharing that with us. She is having a banner day here with 12 points to lead all scorers in this championship game. There is a rebound by the diminutive Shakira Barnes. 5'6", and she gets the pull. There is Clark, and I'm afraid that's going to be an offensive foul. She may start her day at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, but she can't drop her shoulder into a defender.
We said this all tournament long. You cannot plant, you cannot drop the shoulder, you cannot put the forearm in. It's exactly what she did just then. And some good acting that time by Bobby Chitsey as well.
Huge opportunity here for the Lady Chaparrals. A 1-point deficit to overcome. Chance to take the lead here. Still 0-for from three-point land, but 2 would give him the lead. Chitsey, an unbelievable little spinner. She throws it up and off the window around Sandra Guillory, and she gives the Lady Chaps the lead. Looking down low to Clark for the answer. They wanted the and one, but Keani Clark will have a chance here. A great free throw shooter today. She's been 4 of 5 today. On the season, she's a 62% shooter. Tack on to what Jose was saying. This basketball team wouldn't be the same without her either. She leads the team with rebounds, 187 rebounds this year. Not to mention today, she's the team's leading scorer. On most days, she averages 11 points and 7 rebounds. But she has put the Hilltoppers on her back here in this one. Tied up 30-30. It'll stay tied up 30-30, but an offensive rebound by Guillory.
Guillory underneath, grabbing the offensive board. It gives St. Edward's the opportunity to score again.
Looked like she was shot out of a cannon as she came through the lane. Fothery, long 3, too much. Rebound pulled down by Jolly, and we'll do it again. Offensive rebounds now, and Clark will go back to the free throw line. Drew, you talked about how the rebounds were out of whack. Lubbock Christian was bigger on the boards. Now all of a sudden in that possession, St. Edward's starting to respect the glass.
29 rebounds for Lubbock Christian, 22 total for St. Edward's, but you saw right there, 3 right there in a row. And as we've mentioned all tournament long, rebounds are so important because rebounds create possessions and possessions result in points.
Clark the foul there. She makes the first free throw. That gives her team back the lead. Too much on the second one. Rebound fought for, controlled by Lubbock Christian. So it stays. The tie is broken. It's a 1-point edge to St. Edward's, 31-30. Olivia Robertson back to work. Outside, Chitsey wants a 3-ball. Too much mustard on that one. pops out of the back. Fothery out on the wing, drives on Caitlin Cunyas. Pass along the baseline and back out. Shakira Barnes travels. She started and stopped as she tried to get her teardrop runner to go down the lane. Farron Sutton will check in for the first time today, a 5'2" freshman guard from Charlotte, North Carolina. Long way from Charlotte to Austin, Texas. That's where St. Edward's and the Hilltoppers call home. Cunyas crosses up her defender, gives way to Chitsey. 11 seconds on the shot clock. This 2-3 zone defensively for St. Edward's, and another travel. Drew, everybody's starting their steps before they start their dribble.
It goes back to being mentally prepared, and still, you know, even in the last couple of minutes, we've seen maybe something that would resemble championship jitters just a little bit, trying to get ahead of yourself. It's a one-point deficit. You're trying to put your team up by a couple of points, but you have to be able to be fundamentally sound.
Clark dips the shoulder and spins one home. Keani Clark, 16 points now. Her team up by three. Harbin on the far side, brings it back. Ruffy sends it around to Cunyas. Down low, Robertson splits a double team out. Chitsey steps into a three and knocks it down. Bobby Chitsey trying to answer Keani Clark, punch for punch. Chitsey now with 14 points to lead LCU.
Lubbock Christian's first tray ball of the game after 16 attempts.
One of 16. Drew's been harping on it this whole time. A minute to go here in the third. Lubbock Christian got one to go. Can they find another one here in a 33 all tie? Two lead changes in the first three quarters of play. We've been tied once. Bruffy shoots to break the tie and she misses. Guillory with her third rebound of the championship. There's going to be a 4-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock as the freshman guard Farron Sutton yo-yos her dribble at center court. She looks over, gets the call from head coach JJ Real. The former guard herself, Real, over 1,000 points in her career as a Hilltopper player. Guillory underneath the scoop shot, no. 4 seconds, 3 seconds, two. Will she shoot? Oh, Cunyas drew iron that time. It was close. Either way, we go tied to the frantic fourth quarter of play. We wouldn't have it any other way. St. Edward's and Lubbock Christian tied at 33.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
Lubbock Christian normally averages 8 or 9 three-pointers a game. They got their first one here in the third quarter. 1 of 17, but no matter how cold the outside shooting has been, partner, this game is tied at 33 apiece.
And it really comes down to rebounds. It comes back to offensive glass. It comes down to the fundamentals. You know, we mentioned it. 1 for 17 for Lubbock Christian from behind the arc. 5 for 14 for St. Edward's. But there's still a rebound disparity. 32 for Lubbock Christian, 24 for St. Edward's.
They get a takeaway here. Lubbock Christian has won the second and third quarter scoring runs. They won the second quarter 12-11. The third quarter 13-10. St. Edward's got a 12-8 first quarter lead. And here is 2 points for number 15, Hannah Harbin. She's got four now, and Lubbock Christian leads by two. Lubbock Christian has taken the two-point lead, a three-point retort for Haley Jolly, and the lead swings back to St. Edwards, 36-35. Jose Harbor was in the huddle during the third quarter break with St. Edwards. Jose, what was Coach Real preaching?
Thanks, guys. Yeah, Coach Real's telling her, look, we got 10 minutes left. This is what dreams are made of, but she kept harping on them. You got to live in the moment. If you miss a shot, don't worry about it. If you miss, the other team gets a layup, don't worry about it. You got to move on to the next play. She said the shots that they need to make will come down, but it all revolves around the defensive end. Guys?
You hear that all the time, Drew, about pitchers. Got to have that short-term memory loss. Make a bad pitch, give up a home run, forget about it, move on to the next play.
Exactly. Quarterbacks have the same way. Throw a pick, move on. And this time, especially in championship games like this one, you cannot harp on the negative. You've got to focus on what's next.
Double foul called. You don't see that every day. But Hannah Harbin for Lubbock Christian was tied up with Abby Hopper. Harbin 5'10", Hopper 6'1", and they called the double foul. First time we've seen that all weekend.
Which I think means we have run the gambit on all the things you can see in a basketball game.
Because we got a double technical yesterday.
We did.
But not just a double personal foul. Off the drive, Heist steals 2 points back for her team. They lead 37-36. Lexi Fothery not in the lineup right now for St. Edwards. Hopper has it with 8.5 to go. Her team down one. Clark has been the answer to every question today. Bruffy covers her, should cover good enough.
Some days you just can't.
A steal at midcourt by Haley Jolly. Clark now with 18 points. A standing ovation from the Hilltopper bench. Can they make it a 3 or a 4 point game? Jolly just knocked down a 3. Clark knocked down a 2. More scoring here in the fourth. How about another 3? Haley Jolly from Fremont, California dials up a long distance dedication.
Casey Kasem would absolutely be proud of that one, but so is Coach J.J. Real. That's what you're talking about, living in the moment and trying to find your shots. They did just that.
The moment is theirs. There's an up-close miss out of the hands of Olivia Robertson. 41-37, St. Edwards up 4. Their largest lead in this one has been 8. Lubbock Christian has never been up by more than 2. And now the Lady Shaps make a change. Bobby Chitsey back into the ballgame, along with Delaney Gaddis. J.J. Real in year 5, running things for St. Edwards. She is a Hilltopper through and through. Our official review man talking with our officials about the fact that there was a double foul, so the possession arrow does not change. It stays put. 4 points, 7.5 minutes to play here on Championship Sunday in Tulsa. Game 1 of 2. A little bit later today, the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions look to take down the number 1 seeded Dallas Baptist University Patriots. What a great time for Shakira Barnes to get off the schneid. That's her first 2 of the day. Her team up 6.
St. Edwards on a 7-0 run.
A big run here in the fourth quarter. They had not won a quarter since the first. The Hilltoppers in control here in the fourth. 8 on the shot clock, 7. Lady Shaps work the ball around the horn. The 3 for Heist won't go, and there's a rebound foul as Hopper gets tangled up with Bobby Chitsey. And Chitsey now has 4 fouls, Drew. She's the first player in the danger zone with 4.
Look at the frustration there on Bobby Chitsey's face. She knew the moment that she got up, that was a big deal.
The media timeout here comes at 6:42. A big run for St. Edwards. We'll see what Lubbock Christian answer is after the break.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous,
but they're worthwhile?
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
The St. Edward's University Hilltoppers have gotten scoring from six different players. Keani Clark leading the way with 18, Bailey Hill with 9. Three threes for Bailey Hill. Haley Jolly has knocked down a couple threes here in the second half, Drew. They are out to a big lead here in the fourth quarter. Their largest lead of the game was 8 back in the first quarter. They're almost back to that high water mark.
What we talked about here in the fourth quarter, wow, Shakira Barnes with the charge there. We talked about here, it was going to take some runs. It was going to take something, some kind of momentum shifts for one team to get out in front of the other one. And we saw St. Edward's go on a run.
Number 12 that time, doing a good job picking up the foul that time. The drive for Shakira Barnes, that foul against her, her third now. Chitsey staying in the game with 4 fouls for Steve Gomez. That's a kicked ball on Hopper. Drew, if we look to our right, we see exactly what we've seen in each of the quarterfinal and semifinal games. Lexi Fothery is not playing right now, but she cannot sit down. She stays up and elevated to keep that knee loose. And look at this, miscommunication. She zigged when she should have zagged, and Delaney Gaddis has to come back for the ball as Bailey Heist almost threw it away on the inbound.
Well, you've mentioned Lexi Father, who's pacing behind the bench and trying to continue to coach her team up. Well, you're noticing that on the entire St. Edward's bench. People are standing up. They're coaching up. It's a big game, and the entire team is involved, whether on the floor or not.
There's a runner that goes, a kiss off the window, and back in for Barnes. She's got 4. Lubbock Christian now back with it. Remember, this is the defending national champs in all in Division II here in the blue. Jose Harbor was near their sideline a moment ago. Jose?
Appreciate that, guys. Yeah, Coach Gomez was just very calm, just wanted to keep his team, keep his team's head in the game. Told him, look, when we have a good possession, we score. We just got to keep moving the ball. We got to get those wings moving around, set some screens. He wants Bruffy to set high post screens and get the ball moving around. So let's see if that creates some offense for him, guys.
All right. Thank you, Jose. So there's some confusion there. There is no way that is the fifth foul on Hannah Harbin. Now, she got a foul. Don't get me wrong, Drew. But the only player that had 4 fouls a minute ago was Chitsey.
Bobby Chitsey, right. And Steve Gomez, look at the bewilderment. He says, hey, this is 3. There's no way she fouled out.
The entire game would have had to have gotten away from me. Because I thought Bobby Chitsey was the only player with 4 fouls. Now they've got Chitsey with 5 and Harbin with 5 on the score monitor, which means we are not the only ones in the building that are a little confused right now. They'll go to the official review and try and figure it out. See who was there at that time. Take another look at it here, partner. You see Chitsey. Harbin's coming in from the back side. You've got 3 players there that are capable of being called for the foul that include number 3, Bailey Heist. So unfortunately for the officials, it's kind of a you pick 'em. I guess you're trying to determine who made contact first.
And then as we're looking at it, you know, as you mentioned, look at the 2 players from the top and from the back. They swarm for LCU. Who gets the foul call?
I'm still confused as to how Hannah Harbin would have had four fouls. I didn't think she had more than three, but that could have easily slipped past me. I know Chitsey had four.
Well, that was something we conversated about. I didn't think that she had that many.
Bailey Heist has no personal fouls. So if Lubbock Christian were able to get lucky here, it could go against Heist, and they get to keep two of their starters. If it goes against either team, now the officials are going to bring both J.J. Real and Steve Gomez here to center court to talk about this. J.J. Real has had some ups and downs this weekend here. She is a passionate coach, love the way she patrols the sideline. I'm afraid there's no good way this story ends for Steve Gomez, and you can... Oh my gosh, Steve Gomez needs to go buy a lottery ticket. They gave the foul.
They gave it to Bailey Heist.
They gave it to Heist, wow. It's a good day for Steve Gomez. Now his team needs to knock down a couple of shots.
Well, if you're the officials, you don't want to, on a call like that, you don't want to change the flow of the game. So putting it on Bailey Heist would have least affected the game.
And it did, and here's Chitsey with the rebound. Chitsey, a sophomore, Harbin, a senior, both starters for Lubbock Christian. They get to stay in. Their team is down eight, though. 5 minutes to play. They need offense, and they need it in a hurry here. They'll go down low. Harbin fouled, and she will go to the line as she goes between Fothery and Hopper. This is going to be the fourth foul against Abby Hopper. So a foul against Hopper will get us to our final timeout here in the fourth quarter. 4:52 to play. You're seeing all the action of the 15th annual Heartland Conference Tournament right here on the Heartland Conference Sports Network.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
Enough. Yeah, I'm over it.
We shouldn't need commercials to tell you we're powerful.
No thanks.
Genders don't play sports, athletes do.
Steve Gomez and the Lubbock Christian University Lady Chaparrals dodged a bullet on that foul. But what they cannot dodge right now is a 12-4 scoring run. It was 33-33 when the 10-minute clock started here in the fourth quarter. It is 12-4. Then, since then, it has been all St. Edwards. As Hannah Harbin goes to the line here. Harbin has scored 12 points and 14 points in her quarterfinal and semifinal appearances here in the Heartland Conference Tournament. Today, she has five, now six. And if Harbin can get hot, could be good things to come for Lubbock Christian. Neither of these two teams want their season to end, and you can tell in the intensity by which they are playing. Clark inside out that time to Barnes. Fothery, they have to pay so much attention to her on the perimeter. Clark calls for it down low, eight on the shot clock. A three won't go, rebound position. Tapped by Bruffy, controlled by Harbin. Our sideline reporter, Jose Harbor, was near the St. Edwards bench during the timeout. Jose, what do you have for us?
Thanks, guys. Yeah, Coach Real was telling them, look, they're going to try to get it to 54, Bruffy, as much as they can. She's going to get touches, so watch for that. And she was preaching, look, we only need at least five more stops. Five more stops, the game is ours. Guys?
Well, there's one right there.
You're absolutely right, Drew. Stop number one. Keep track of it here. Look at the backwards pass. Feathery misses from point blank range. The rebound to Lubbock Christian. Fothery that time, a rare miss from right there in the paint.
Well, I'm curious to see why Fothery, unless it's an injury, why she's not been more part of this game. She's only got one foul. It's not a foul trouble issue for her.
I think they just have to manage her minutes. I think that's just part of trying to nurse that injury all season long. Chitsey steps into a three, and it rattles around and won't go. Clark had it tied up by Harbin. They'll reset the shot clock. The possession arrow will keep us on the end. Look at the rebound here. Harbin doing battle with Keani Clark.
Keani Clark did not like that jump ball call whatsoever. You saw the frustration on her face immediately.
The 50-50 ball's all going Lubbock Christian's way right now. Bruffy falls down, all 6'4" of her, and they'll get the runner in the lane, missing from Gaddis's right hand. Barnes brings us back to the Hilltoppers end. 3:15 to go in the fourth quarter. Shakira Barnes directs traffic. The Blinn Junior College transfer by way of Snook, Texas. Barnes drives the high shot off the window, no. Bobby Chitsey again with the rebound. 14 points and 7 boards for the super sophomore Chitsey. Well, Jose told us he thought the offense would go through Bruffy. She drives, passes, and throws it away. The turnover, the 10th of the day for Lubbock Christian.
That was a miscommunication, but it was also defensive disruption. It was the disruption inside that created that miscommunication.
Stop number 2 for St. Edwards. Coach Reel said the magic number is 5. Fathery skips it all the way across to Jolly. Down no to Clark. It's worked all day. Oh, she's capped, blocked by the conference and Lubbock Christian's all-time blocks leader. Bruffy, coast to coast, she scores. Tess Bruffy showing you why she's the player of the year in the HC.
St. Edwards has to score right here. You can feel Lubbock Christian starting to get hot. You can feel the momentum swinging. You can feel the fact that Tess Bruffy wants to take this team and put it on her back. You have to score right here.
4-point lead. Clark, with both feet in the lane, gets the offensive rebound. The putback won't go, and there's another board for Lubbock Christian. 4 points down, the ball, and a minute and 40 seconds between one of these two teams and a conference crown. Fathery ties up Chitsey. The possession arrow will give it back to St. Edwards. A big play by a big-time player, Lexi Fathery, ties her up.
And it couldn't have come at a better time for St. Edwards. First time the possession arrow has gone their way all game, and it comes at a pivotal moment with a 1:38 to play.
295 points this season for Lexi Fathery, a second-team all-conference selection, and one of the 1, 2, 3 seniors for J.J. Real. A moment for one of our players to tie their shoes, and we are back at it. You hear the LCU faithful chanting for their team. Their coach, Steve Gomez, calls a timeout. Exactly 60 seconds to play, and Drew, this one makes the matchup from a year ago pale in comparison. That was a runaway by 23 points for Lubbock Christian on their way to a national title. No such luck for either team today. This one's going down to the wire.
Absolutely it has, but you know, one of the things that you would like to say, okay, well, both teams have played well, and that's the reason why it's going so well. But I'm not so sure that that's the best analysis of this. Shooting woes have really continued for both of these squads. They've not been able to find their rhythm in their particular strengths. They've allowed some miscommunication and some mental errors to happen. I think they had championship jitters all day long. The last 90 seconds are really going to be pivotal for both of these squads.
Both teams only shooting about 33% from the floor. The biggest difference in the game had been 3-pointers, 7 of 17 for St. Edwards. 1 of 20 for 5% for Lubbock Christian. But rebounds and scoring opportunities at the free throw line have made a difference here, and we have a 4-point game. St. Edwards has the lead. They have the rock. They have a little bit of time on their side. Fathery steps through the lane. He's stolen away by Heist.
Appropriately.
Absolutely. the team's top three-point shooter with a steal. Buffy for three, no. Rebound by Shakira Barnes. A first-team all-conference superstar. Only her second rebound, but a big one. Now there'll be a reach foul here. That's going to go on Delaney Gaddis.
They had to stop the clock. They had to break up the momentum.
The cheerleaders telling you to fear the GOAT. The GOAT trying to cement a championship win here today. And Gaddis taking on the role of obligatory fouler to try and get us to the bonus here. Five fouls now. Four against St. Edward's, five against Lubbock Christian. This will put Abby Hopper at the line. Hopper scored 14 points in the win against Lubbock Christian during the regular season and ranked in the top 20 in the conference in rebounds per game. Here, all that matters right now is free throws. She gets them to go. 47-41, the lead expands to six. Lubbock Christian burns another timeout here with 56.4 seconds to go. During the regular season, Lubbock Christian and St. Edward's split their regular season meetings. There was a loss on January 19th, 58-50, where Lubbock Christian fell to these Hilltoppers. Then the Lady Shaps won at home in overtime, 84-80. This rubber match has been all we could ask for here. St. Edward's on top of the hill right now, up six.
Well, and we've talked about it all tournament long, Corey. The fact of the matter is that you have to make the plays when they are presented to you. And so far, I'm not seeing this team, either one of these teams, do precisely that. In the last 60 seconds, if you're afforded an opportunity, you cannot miss it.
Lubbock Christian won a Heartland Conference tournament title a year ago. They won a national championship a year ago. And as Harbin spins through the lane, she'll get two free throws here with the clock stopped on 52 seconds exactly. The foul charged against Abby Hopper is her fifth. The young lady from Friendship High School's day is going to be done. No basket. It'll be a shot for two here, and this will bring Sandra Guillory in. The day done for Abby Hopper. 5 points, eight rebounds. A great tournament performance for her. Abby Hopper over 160 points this year, and a horrible time for a missed free throw drill.
Absolutely. Hannah Harbin's been money for the most part, especially during the tournament. A very bad time to miss a free opportunity to score. And over here to our right, watch the game within a game between the officials and Coach J.J. Real here in this final minute.
Don't want to get a tee. It's still a close game. We're going to get a timeout, though, for St. Edward's. 30-second timeout with 52 seconds to play. We will step aside one more time. Back to the UMAC after this.
It's on us to stop sexual assault.
In any way that we can.
To get a friend home safe.
To never blame the victim.
It's on us.
To stand up.
To make our community safe for all.
It's on us.
It's on us to look out for each other at parties.
It's on us.
To be more than just a bystander.
To step up and say something.
It's on us, all of us.
To stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Back inside the Union Multipurpose Activities Center in Tulsa, Oklahoma. We are 52 seconds away from crowning a champion in the Heartland Conference Women's Basketball Tournament. St. Edward's took the timeout. J.J. Real drew something up on the dry erase board. Her team has the 5-point lead, and they will go to the foul line here. And Shakira Barnes, a almost 70% free throw shooter, will go to the line here. Less than a second went off the clock between the inbounds and the timeout. Barnes on the day, 4 points on 2 of 6 shooting. This is her first trip to the free throw line. She put too much on that one. Bobby Chitsey back into the game with four fouls. Chitsey with four. Harbin with four. Bruffy with just one. Tess Bruffy with 9 points and nine rebounds. Got a block out here if you're Lubbock Christian, but doesn't matter if Barnes makes the free throw. 6 points now, the difference. And Lubbock Christian only has one three. They need another one here. They'll go down low for the quick two. Bruffy, the left-handed shot won't go. Rebound fought for. Fothery comes up with it, and Bailey Heist commits the foul.
Here's the St. Edward's team, picked number five in the preseason poll. Comes into this tournament seeded number one, and could be, if they can hold on, 35 seconds away from avenging a loss in the championship last year and capturing a Heartland Conference title.
They put Lexi Fothery at the line, an 82% free throw shooter. Fothery, her first make of the day from the charity stripe. She is 65 for 79 this season. She puts them both down. 8 points now to tie St. Edward's largest lead of the game, going back to the first 10 minutes of this championship game. Harbin to Heist. Lubbock Christian needs points. They go down low for the high percentage shot. The left-handed shot for the Lubbock Christian star goes down, and now she wants a timeout. As Tess Bruffy calls timeout here with 20.4 seconds to go. That'll be the last timeout for Lubbock Christian. After this, we will bring you an interview with the winning coach. Our Jose Harbor will run down the winning coach in this one. We will bring you post-game press conference coverage. We also hope to effort the cutting down of the nets here inside the John Q. Hammonds Arena, the UMAC that's been our home for 4 days here in Tulsa. This site hosting this event for the second time. It's been a great week of basketball here in Tulsa. Topper likes what he sees on the scoreboard. He wants to cheer for a second ever St. Edward's Heartland Conference crown. They won it all, Drew, in 2014 over St. Mary's. That one kind of similar to this one today. It was an 83-71 game. If St. Edward's makes their free throws down the stretch here, that may be about the same differential in this one, although we didn't score nearly as many points.
Absolutely not, but this is a St. Edward's team who has had to claw. They've had to fight off Lubbock Christian, take nothing away from LCU, the defending national champions who gave St. Edward's everything they wanted, and we're not done yet.
Jolly has her run of the line. Full court pressure and an immediate foul here on Delaney Gaddis. Gaddis will pick up her fourth personal. This is Keani Clark. Keani Clark, partner, they don't ask us for a vote, but if I'm voting, this is your tournament MVP right here, at least your championship MVP.
Unquestionably, this woman has put the team on her back, as you've said, time and again. She's such a danger, running and gunning up and down the court, but also inside. Keani Clark is definitely an all-tournament team in my book.
She has 20 points. 7 of 10 from the free throw line for Keani Clark, the only player with 20 points on this championship Sunday. 12.3 seconds remaining. 52-44. St. Edward's going to ratchet up the defense one more time here on the inbounds.
This would be stop number 5.
3 for Bruffy, too strong. Fothery fights Heist for the rebound. It's out of bounds. It'll stay with the team in blue. 7.3 seconds now. That's all that remains. The chance for a return trip to the postseason is ticking away from Lubbock Christian, and the Hilltoppers from St. Edward's are Heartland Conference champions again. They defeat Lubbock Christian 52-44 for their second ever Heartland Conference title. J.J. Real shakes Steve Gomez's hand at center court. All class, all heart, these two teams all season long, all tournament long. but it is St. Edward's who will advance to the NCAA Division II National Tournament with their victory here today, 52-44 over Lubbock Christian. Our camera's taking you inside the huddle, inside the adulation. You can feel the love the Hilltoppers have right now as they know they are going dancing.
Well, as we mentioned, they were picked number 5 in the conference to begin the year. They called them underdogs and long shots, but today, sir, they call them champions.
They were underdogs a year ago as a 6th seed as they took LCU to the championship round. Now, on this championship Sunday, the crown is theirs, the title is theirs, and they will live to play another game. 2017 continues. Jose Harbor is with a very happy J.J. Reel.
That's right, guys. I'm with J.J. Reel, coach of the 2017 Heartland Conference Tournament Champions. Congratulations. This was a rematch of last year's championship game. You got your revenge. Talk about it.
Well, I don't, you know, it's so surreal. You plan and you work for this moment for an entire year, and then it gets here, and it's almost like you can't even enjoy it. You don't even know what to say. Lubbock is a great program. They have a great team. We have nothing but respect for them. I think in the end, we have 3 seniors that are just tremendous leaders, and they were just, they just pulled us through in the end. You know, I don't even know. I mean, I guess we're just going to ride this wave of emotion and happiness and joy. And we're a veteran squad, and we'll figure out what we're going to do next on Monday or Tuesday.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you. Congratulations. Guys, I'll send it back to you.
Thank you, Jose. Thank you, Coach Reel. She's been so generous with her time all week. They are announcing the all-tournament team now, the public address announcer. Bobby Chitsey being named to the all-tournament team as we listen in here, Drew. Well-deserved for her. She will come to center court and get her plaque. Bobby Chitsey, the sophomore, with 3 great games here. She's greeted by the commissioner, Lexi Fothery.
Go.
I'm joined with Lexi Fothery. You're a champion. You got revenge from last year. Just talk about this game.
There's so much emotion. You know, we came in, we were ready. We were ready, and we did it. And never once did I doubt my team, never once. And God, I'm just speechless right now. The feeling is so surreal. It feels amazing. It feels amazing.
Congratulations.
Lexi Fothery named to the all-tournament team. Keani Clark, your tournament MVP, we called it, partner. Nobody more deserving.
Keani Clark was the beast for this team and absolutely one of the biggest reasons why the St. Edward's squad was able to pull off the championship victory.
Shakira Barnes, Keani Clark, Lexi Fothery. Coach J.J. Reel told us in the interview her 3 seniors made the difference this time, and you see the smiles on their face. They are going to the NCAA Division II tournament. Congratulations, ladies, you earned it. The hardware gets continued to be handed out here. Tony Spigarelli, our commissioner, hands out the Heartland Conference Tournament runner-up trophy to Caitlin Cunyas and the Lubbock Christian Lady Chaparrals. A great season for them. They finished with a record of 19-11. Runners-up in the Heartland Conference. They were your national champs and conference champs 1 year ago when they defeated St. Edward's 75-52. But today, St. Edward's able to extract their revenge, as Jose Harbor mentioned just a moment ago. They get their plaque with the tournament title plaque. Goes to the ladies wearing the championship blue shirts. Drew, it says champions right across the front. Those are the Hilltoppers from St. Edward's.
And well-deserved at that. You know, you have to just say this to St. Edward's. This is a chippy team. This is a team that had to fight. This is a team that had to scrap. And they deserve it.
The PA announcer announces the Hilltoppers as the Heartland Conference champs for 2017. The commish hands off the hardware, and the celebration is on in Austin, Texas. They won 5 of their last 6 games. They will finish this tournament with a record of 20 wins against 8 losses. Congratulations to the players, to Coach J.J. Real, her assistant coaches, Jamie Kedlick and Matt Miner. They've had 3 title game appearances in 5 years, and now they have a conference crown, a perfect picture for the team that will represent the Heartland Conference in the postseason. Welcome back courtside here at the UMAC, everybody. Corey Riggs and Drew Brent, Jose Harbin have been working hard all day long. And partner, a fantastic final game here on the women's side. Your final thought?
Unbelievable. You know, we watched this team all conference tournament long have to chip away and scrap. And this was both teams. You know, some mental mistakes for both squads. But at the end, you found the team that needed to win it more. They wanted to win it more. It was they made less mistakes, but you know, congratulations to St. Edwards. They're going dancing.
They are indeed. St. Edwards, a great finish to their season with a conference title. They win the regular season conference crown. They win the tournament crown, and they advance to the NCAA tournament. They are going to cut down the nets. We are not done working. We will be back a little bit later with the men's championship. We'll have the University of Arkansas Fort Smith Lions trying to knock off the number one seed, the Patriots of Dallas Baptist University. But enjoy the live streaming coverage of the net cutting ceremony as well as the post-game press conferences. More on the Heartland Conference Sports Network as we roll on this championship Sunday.
Conference. Get in the game. Heartland Conference. Get in the game.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Women's Basketball Championships, March 21st, 22nd, and 24th at Alumni Hall in Columbus, Ohio. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
Sportsmanship is defined as the conduct and attitude of participants in sports, especially when considered commendable, as in fair play, courtesy, and grace in winning or losing.
Sportsmanship is a key value found within St. Edward's University Athletic.
How do you play?
Fairness.
Honesty.
Respect.
Playing sports gives us...
character.
Friendship.
Strength. Respect the players.
Respect the coaches.
Respect the officials.
Respect the game.
We are.
We are.
We are.
We are St. Edward's University.
We respect the game.
It's not whether you win or lose. It's how you play the game.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
At Rogers State University, we keep things personal.
It all starts here.
We make sure our graduates get the most out of their education.
RSU has campuses in Claremore, Bartlesville, and Pryor, with on-campus housing and a wide variety of programs to suit your needs.
It all starts here.
Rogers State University.
I knew I would earn my degree from a great school, but I never imagined this experience. It's changed the way I think about my future and transformed how I see my world.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
At Newman University, you'll receive more than just a degree. You'll receive a degree of merit, a degree of character, a degree of difference. Learn more at newmanu.edu.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
We open our arms to students from around the corner and from around the world.
No matter where we're from, all Dust Devil student athletes play for the love of our sport, the love of our team, and the love of our university. If you can play here, you can play.
If you can play,
you can play.
Om du kan spela, så kan du spela.
Si muchas rat, muchas rat.
Si puedes jugar, puedes jugar.
If you can play, you can play.
I came here to get my degree at a great school. Along the way, I worked at an orphanage in India and taught school in Peru. It's changed how I look at the world and how I see my future.
Newman University in Wichita. Newman is a family that comes together to excel in the classroom and on the field. As the only private NCAA Division II university in Kansas, our student athletes are uniquely prepared for success beyond college. Newman University empowering graduates to transform society.
Defining moments. Championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
He is the God who sees me. He knows who I am becoming and who I will one day be. The kingdom of God. This is no small stake. With all my heart, mind, and strength, I will answer the call.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
This is the U that goes beyond a bachelor's degree. This is the International U, Texas A&M International University. Learn how to take your talents further at tamiu.edu.
Whoever you are,
after a 52-44 loss in the 2017 Heartland Conference Women's Basketball Championship Final, we have head coach Steve Gomez. To our left is Hannah Harbin, and to the right is Bailey Heiss. Coach, just open us up with a statement, and then we'll get into questions.
Yeah, tough, hard-fought game. I mean, low scoring. Obviously, at the end of 3 days of playing, teams are struggling a little. And, you know, you got to make shots to – shots have to fall. I mean, I think we took, even at times, the great shot that didn't go, and – they made some pretty tough shots. They banked in a couple runners in the lane, and you know those points make a big difference. And so, you know, turnover numbers were low. I thought it was a good, rugged game, but just the shooting percentage for both teams weren't real high. And so, a lot of times the team that just happens to rattle some in is the team that ends up winning. And so, it wasn't lack of effort on either team, and so just a close game that didn't go our way.
Coach, Tess Bruffy shot 5 for 19 from the field, but Bobby Chitsey was able to knock in 14 points. How was she able to leave her impact on the offensive end in specific?
Yeah, but I mean, she did a good job just being patient on the post until she finally got the shot she wanted. And, you know, that's just the way it is. Tess has carried us a lot of games. She's had some big games, and, you know, today it didn't go in as well for her, but she did a lot of other things for us as well during the game that may not show up in statistics. So she just played so hard this whole weekend and really left a lot on the court.
Coach, as a team, you shot 1 for 22 from the three-point line. What was your plan of action when threes just weren't falling? What did you tell your team?
Yeah, we just want to take the right shot. I mean, all you can do is take the right shot. And if it goes in, that's good. If it doesn't go in, then next time take the right shot again. And that's all you can do. I mean, you can't then change what's been good for you. And so if you have good shooters shooting good shots, that's why you run offense. And so nothing we can worry about right there.
Tess's performance today, just a tough day shooting the ball. I mean, did anyone do anything specifically defensively to you know, force her to have a tough day?
Well, n- Not necessarily. I mean, they play good defense. I mean, it's a good defensive team, but I don't know necessarily that they did some great strategy that caused her not to be able to score. I think there were maybe some opportunities that would have been good to see her perhaps go to contact even harder to make them allow her to get to the free throw line. That might have been a good positive play to make, but she did a good job trying to score. She's done a lot this weekend. I think she was a little fatigued, and so it just didn't work out today.
Hannah, you had to play a good chunk of that fourth quarter with four fouls. Just talk about kind of how that impacted the game, especially late, because it was really back and forth, and then Santa just started getting a little separation late.
I know. I think for me, it was kind of hard just to play smart. It kind of limits how hard you can rebound offensively, just because you're aware of the possibility of getting tangled up and still getting a foul called. I still think that everyone was able to go hard and go tough, and they just, like Coach said, rattled in a few more shots than we did.
And Bailey, talk about just from a player's aspect, how just what's going through your mind on a day like today from the three-point line for you guys. You guys average 8 or 9. You guys have set a program record this year for three-pointers in a game, and then today they just weren't falling.
Yeah, I think, like Coach said, we were taking the right shots, and that's what he was telling us. If the three is the right shot, take it. If we needed to get it in, pass the ball inside. If we needed to get that one more pass for the shot, then pass it. So just taking the right shots, and they just weren't falling today. So frustrating, definitely, but I'm really proud of the girls and how they fought.
Let's talk about your final season at Lubbock Christian. Coming off a national championship from last year, just talk about what this year has meant to you and your time at LCU.
It's been an amazing experience. I've loved every second of it. It's character building, just going through the tough times, and these girls are amazing, and I wouldn't trade them for the world. So,
Hannah, kind of same question to you.
It's just really been an incredible year for me. Just a lot of fun making really, I would say, strong relationships with my teammates. They're really my sisters now, and I just, I wouldn't trade that for a national championship, another one,
Coach, do you think the format of the tournament with St. Edward's getting a little bit of extra rest had anything to do with the ending today?
No, not necessarily. I mean, again, if the top seeds get an advantage, that's what the regular season's for. I mean, it's you just need to win during the season, and even for postseason stuff, you just need to take care of business and win games. And so there's never a reason to have an excuse. Teams are going to be tired at the end of the year no matter how many days rest they get between games. So who knows, but we've had three close games with them, and they could have won all three, we could have won all three, we split. So, yeah, I saw two good teams sort of trying just to survive and fight it out. So, I don't think that had a big deal.
Whoever you want to be, find your future with us. Our UAFS.
The first step to discovering the world starts by discovering who you are and who God created you to be. You have the potential to change the world by learning how to serve the world. We can show you how. Dallas Baptist University, developing servant leaders, transforming lives.
Defining moments, championship dreams. Share the experience with your family and friends. The 2017 NCAA Division II Men's Basketball Elite Eight, March 22nd, 23rd, and 25th at the Sanford Pentagon in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Visit ncaa.com/tickets for your tickets today.
If you're the band Europe, you love a final countdown.
It's what you do.
If you want to save 15% or more on car insurance, you switch to GEICO. It's what you do.
The academics at LCU, they're very strenuous, but they're worthwhile.
I would honestly say that the academics are top-notch. Being in small classrooms and getting to have those personal relationships with your professors really enhances the academic environment and academic experience. It's very easy to learn when you have professors who genuinely know you and genuinely care about your growth intellectually.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
When you meet a St. Mary's graduate, when you meet anybody that has any sort of involvement with St. Mary's, you'll see that they're all good people. In fact, they're great people that care about the community, that care about what they do on a daily basis. And I'm proud to have had the opportunity to attend a university that cares so much about community, about students, and really does give back in a way that can't be matched around the nation.
I'm getting a lot for my money here at LCU.
The value of coming to LCU is priceless. I mean, you get to work around professionals who love you dearly, who love what they're doing, and to put those two together, you can't put a price on it.
I think the most valuable thing about LCU is that I'm receiving an excellent education, but I'm also being spiritually guided through that education.
If a student is on the fence about coming to LCU, this place is one that will change your life forever.
Believe, belong, be blue at Lubbock Christian University.
That's what we do. I'm probably not. I probably wasn't either.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
We're here with the 2017 Heartland Conference Tournament Champions, the St. Edwards Hilltoppers, 52-44 winners over Lubbock Christian today. We have head coach J.J. Real. To the left is Keani Clark, Shakira Barnes, and Lexi Fothery. Coach, start us off with a question, or excuse me, a statement, and then we'll get into questions.
It was a great game, unbelievable matchup between two really good programs. Lubbock Christian is a great team. They're incredibly difficult to play year in and year out. They run a great system. Their kids are class acts, and I just thought it was a battle down to the very end. I think maybe the last 5 minutes, last 6 minutes, I mean, these three, I think our senior leadership just was the difference. I think our will to win and our will to be successful just kind of outweighed those guys over there, and we made a few more plays down the stretch. Just really happy for these three. These three have been probably one of the best senior classes to come through in a really long time, and they've been great on the court, but what they've done as far as our culture and our tradition and just their character and them as people far outweighs the basketball piece, and I'm just really, really proud and happy for them.
Keani, tournament MVP. What does it mean to you? You're going up against arguably one of the best players in the nation, Tess Bruffy, and 18 points, 7 or 8 boards. What did you do? What was working? 20 points, sorry.
I just think I stayed within myself. The tournament MVP could have been any one of us three up here. If you look back at the last three games that we played, Lexi really carried us the first night. Lexi carried us the first night, and then last night we were with 20, and then I guess today was my day. Being that it was a championship game, I think that's why I got the title. But like I said, it could have been any of us three. It was just working within the game plan, and my shot was on, or my moves, not really my shot. But they were working, and they kept giving it to me, so we're good.
Down the stretch, Bruffy managed back-to-back blocks, still close. Was there ever any doubt in your mind after those blocks?
No, she's going to get her blocks. She's 6'4", I'm 5'11". She's got the reach. I didn't really throw my double moves, and she got the blocks, but like I said, we were up, we stayed within ourselves, and we got the win. So.
Lexi, all year long, when you've been in the game, when you've been starting, you've been the go-to as far as scoring. Today, it wasn't going. What adjustments did you make in your head? It was clear later on. You're holding off on shots and finding the hot hand. What kind of adjustment was that for you?
I've learned, you know, when I'm off, I just really have to come out on the defensive end, and that's what I really tried to do, just focus on my defense. I mean, my shots weren't falling, but keys, woos were, and I trusted my teammates. And, you know, when it comes down to it, we we win our games on the defensive end, so I just tried to make every play that I could.
Shakira, 7 assists. So one of your best assist games in a while, after putting up some points and everything like that. What allows you to see the floor so well? What kind of trust do you have in your teammates to be able to dish that out?
Just our everyday hard work and on and off the court. I feel like we do the little things right, and just finding them and being confident that they'll make the shot is easy. So I think me assisting the ball, having confidence in them, gives me the confidence that they'll knock down the shot when I pass it.
Coach, looking forward. Because this isn't it. Now you've got an automatic berth in the South Central Regional Tournament. Do you think your team has the potential to make an impact there?
Absolutely. We think and believe that we're as good as anyone else in the South Central Region, and we're certainly going to enjoy this and live in this moment for a day or so. But Tuesday, it'll be back to business. And I mean, this group has been saying all along, this year was about leaving a legacy, and they've certainly done that now by being the only team to ever sweep as far as St. Edward's history, and they've been saying all along they want to be the only St. Ed's team to ever win a game in the NCAA tournament, and with these three right here, I mean, I don't know. I like our chances.
Coach, how sweet was it to turn the tables and knock off Lubbock Christian today after losing a year ago?
Well, you know, last year when we lost to Lubbock, we were in a totally different situation as far as where we were as a team. I don't know that it was as much of a revenge factor or that we even thought about it in that sense. It was just about they were one more team that was in our way to accomplishing what we set out to accomplish. And so I think we kept it more on that. We always keep things about us. We say just be us. And obviously we prepare for the people that we play, but at the end of the day, it's about us and us doing the things that we need to do to be successful, and I thought we did that tonight, or today, rather.
Long weekend, you know, I've been here as long as you guys have, and so, you know, I know it's... Well, I don't know. You guys have been through quite a bit of fights. So just kind of explain, you know, obviously it's kind of come all to a head at this moment. You guys are the winners. Just talk about just this process this whole weekend, short rest, everything.
Well, I think we obviously had the luxury of playing the first game on Thursday, and I think that helped us down the stretch today. Certainly, I think it did. But I think the biggest thing for us in moving forward and trying to regroup and get ready for next week is to handle our emotions and the emotional and the mental letdown that we're going to have after this. These kids have been working for a year almost to the day for this exact moment, and they've accomplished that. And so I think now it's about us figuring out how we can get ourselves back and focused on the next task at hand. I mean, they're athletes. We'll recover, and they'll be fine. They'll be ready to go as far as physically by Tuesday. I think the biggest challenge for us is more mental and emotional.
Coach, back to the game a little bit, and then maybe Lexi, kind of the same question. The difference in the game today, just going down the stat sheet, 1-for-22 from three-point for Lubbock Christian. Was it something you guys were doing defensively? Because, I mean, they're a team that doesn't live and die by the three, but it's certainly a huge part of their game.
You know, we told the kids this morning in our team meeting and our final film and prep that it was going to be about defense. When we played them at home, I think the score was 58-50. When we played them last week at their place, they got into the 80s in an overtime loss for us. And we're much more successful when the score stays low. And our motto and the things that we kept saying all the entire game, and these guys can echo this, is that we had to be more excited about the opportunity to defend every time down the floor. And I think the kids were more excited about the opportunity to defend. They didn't live in the moment of missing a shot or empty possessions. I think that was key the last 5 minutes when we kind of, you talked about the two blocks Bruffy had on Key. I think we were just more excited about the opportunity to defend, and that we were had a sense of urgency and we were engaged. We were purposeful in our communication. And I think in the end, that was really the difference.
Lexi, kind of same question to you. What about today defensively was working for you guys that maybe didn't work a couple weeks ago when you played Lubbock at Lubbock?
Just not having as many breakdowns. I mean, we did have a couple, but not nearly as many as when we played them there. We always stressed purposeful communication, and we had a lot of that today. You know, we were just in the right places at the right time, getting rebounds, not letting them have all the offensive rebounds.
Thank you all.